So Florida doesn't have anything to hang their head about as far as record-wise is concerned. They had moved to number one in the nation. This, of course, will affect that as far as the polls are concerned. The seconds are ticking away. They're counting them off. And it is 3-2-1. And the football game is over at Jacksonville's Gator Bowl as Georgia defeats Florida by a score of 24-3. So a long, tough afternoon for Florida as far as trying to get points on the board is concerned. Kerwin Bell, statistically, having a great afternoon. An afternoon that he, of course, is a sophomore, but any National Football League scout would look at a guy that's been able to rack up 400 yards passing against this kind of a defense and would be pretty impressed.
Well, from the opening kickoff, the Georgia Bulldogs dominated the line of scrimmage, and that was the key this Saturday afternoon.
Well, Galen Hall is talking with some of the reporters as they get ready to go off the field. The fans racing onto the field, some of the Georgia fans, have broken through a barrier on the far side and are racing across the field. And the security people are trying to hold them off a little bit. Of course, they're delirious about that big win this afternoon, as that will certainly rise Georgia's stock, defeating Florida by a score of 24-3 here at the Gator Bowl in Jacksonville this afternoon. Jim, any more comments?
Not really. I need some Excedrin, I think.
We'll have some more to say and some other facts in just a moment, but right now we'll take time out for these messages. Well, we're back as the police and security people in Jacksonville are trying to keep the fans away from the goalposts over there. The Georgia fans swarming onto the field after the game was over, looking to tear the goalpost down. But it doesn't look like it's going to happen this afternoon in the Gator Bowl.
Well, it looks like it's Argentina out there in a World Cup final or something. They're obviously excited about knocking off the number one team in the nation and getting a bit carried away. But the police seem to have the situation under control. Exuberant energy. There you see passing 408 for the Gators, 436 total offense, but look at 344 rushing the football, heating that clock up for the Georgia Bulldogs. Just a complete victory, offense, defense, special teams for the Georgia Bulldogs.
Penalty-wise, Florida penalized only 3 times for 20 yards. Georgia 6 times for 41. Turnovers for the Gators 2 and for Georgia 1. And time of possession, Florida actually had the football longer than Georgia. 32 minutes and 17 seconds. And the story is the scoreboard, though. 24-3 and a couple of big runs and some fine running backs for the University of Georgia. Plus the blocking that they got up front, too.
And the big runs, they struck like lightning when they had to and they got on the board quickly.
Well, next week, the University of Florida Gators will be at home hosting the Kentucky Wildcats at Florida Field. That should be a great one. With 2 games remaining on the schedule, the Kentucky Wildcats and, of course, the Florida State University Seminoles to cap off the season. And so the Florida Gators right now have lost the first game that they have lost since the beginning of last season. As you look at the Matthews Bridge in Jacksonville at the Gator Bowl,